Hey, fourth graders. This week, the new lesson is learning how to put down our fingers. Now, the first thing I taught this week was playing Twinkle Twinkle. But I'm also teaching on page 14, putting down our second finger and our first finger. Now, this part's for violin, and I'll show you in a second about viola, cello, and viola. Twinkle Twinkle's about the same thing, just different strings. D, D, A, A, 1, 1, A. And for the new notes, those are on the D string, F sharp with 2, E with 1. For cello, D, D, A, A, 1, 1, A. For our new notes, those are F sharp and the D string, and first finger, and open D. For the bass, playing Twinkle Twinkle, our new notes are on the D string, F sharp with fourth finger, for F sharp and first finger, for E. Now my violin players and viola players, I've been working on 4 points here with you this week, and one is elbow underneath the instrument. It swings like a hammock underneath. Straight arm, a little speed bump at the wrist, square top fingers, and fingernails cut short facing your nose. When we put our hand into position, we look at the creases of our fingers above the plane of the fingerboard, and we work on squaring our fingers like this. When we place our first finger on the D string, we want a shape that looks like that. And then a second finger there. Now, I don't have tapes on my violin, but you'll put your first finger on the first tape, our second finger here. Remind the thumb to stay relaxed, and try to make sure there's a little bit of space underneath the hand, right here, right there. When we play second finger F sharp, we have to press firm in the string. You'll notice that you'll get lines on your fingertips. Those are normal. They'll go away after a little while, and your fingers will get tougher. They'll get calluses on there. Here's the sound of F sharp, like in the piece New Note F sharp on page 14. You want this sound. You might get this sound. That means we need to press firmer in the string, so it has a ringing quality to it. The next piece is new note E, and that's the next thing to start working on. For my viola friends, it's very, very similar. We want to still make sure that we've got our elbow underneath the instrument, a straight arm from knuckle to elbow with a bump in the wrist, fingertips with square tops, fingernails cut short, nails facing your nose. When we move it here to the nut, that's this part of the violin or viola, the side of our hand is here, and we want those creases of the fingers above the plane of the fingerboard. We make a square with our finger, and I would practice this 10 times every day, pressing into the string, and then holding first finger, pressing with second finger deep into the string. Feel it sink down. You will have lines in your fingertips like this. Don't worry, it's not permanent, but it will toughen up your fingers. You want this sound. If it's a little too light, you get that sound. We want to sink in deep to the string. That's all on page 14. Cello players, our secret is we need to have a wing like an eagle, not a fried chicken wing stuck to our arm. We need to have a thumb on the spine of the neck, right here on the back, not sticking over and not collapse like that. We need it bent on its tip. When you bring your hand and fingers over here, it's kind of like a C shape. Now, I don't have any tape on this cello, but this is our first finger. It goes about there on the first tape closest to the ceiling. Third finger next. Our 2 and 3 kind of act like buddies that are always connected together. Whenever we move 3, 2 goes with it. So this is our F sharp finger, and this is our first finger, E finger. When we move between them, our middle finger and ring finger move together. That's 2 and 3. Now cello players, you might hear this sound. That means we need to press a little deeper in the string, so it rings. Just like the violins, we're going to have our fingertips with little lines on them. Don't worry, they go away. Our fingers get tougher with time.
Bass friends, it's serious now. Pressing down these strings is a big deal. So I want you working on your finger strength, and same as the cellos, I want a wing here instead of a fried chicken wing. We want thumb and hand making this shape on the bass. Our first finger is the note E. You might get this sound. That means sink deep, let gravity help us. Now, to play F sharp, we bring 2, 3, 4 to the party. All the fingers down now. You might find that your pinky collapses a little bit. See if you can get that one to bump out so we have a strong shape. And then open D. Remember, this is not an elbow rest. It's gotta be in the air. Hey everybody, I'm finishing up this video from the wonderful building in Laverne called Laverne Street Music. It's an old Carnegie building, started as a library. Gorgeous place to make music. You'll hear a big echo sound in the background while I'm talking to you today. I wanted to talk about some things that can go wrong to look out for this week. These are bad habits to avoid. Everyone will have a bad habit from time to time, and it's just important that we are aware of them and we can start correcting them. So let's talk about our violin viola friends first. Remember, hold this wrist up here when you're not using it and work on fingertips just like this. Avoid the pizza delivery boy girl thing. It's important to deliver pizzas, but not when we're playing violin or viola. So always promote your arm to be doing this kind of shape. A little bit of space right in here. Where is it? Oh, it's hard to do this backwards. There, right in there. Make sure there's a little bit of space underneath the neck for your hand to do that. Now, one of the first things your hand is going to want to do when you try to put down a finger on the string, violin and viola friends, is your brain's going to say, I need more power in the string, deep in the string. And your hand's like, well, how about I try this? And your brain's going to go, no hand, nice try. But we need wrist power. This is actually a stronger shape than this is. Try it on your own arm at home. Try to squeeze like this with a collapsed wrist and a duck bill face. Squeeze like that and tell me how hard you can squeeze. Pretty hard, right? Now try it like this, a C shape. Now we've really got power in the string. And that's what this is here. So the first bad habit we're gonna probably try is that wrist collapse. Keep it straight, line from elbow to middle finger knuckle. Little speed bump right there. Here's the next thing that might happen. Our hand might sink a little bit too low and fingers try to play like this. Now look how they're facing to the sky instead of facing towards our nose. So this is good. And then this is a habit that happens here. Now the reason that happens is because the hand sinks down too low and then fingers are almost forced to be flat, but we want them to be on their tips. So that when we have lines from our fingers from pressing down the strings, they're on the tip of the finger instead of right here in the fattier part of the finger, okay? Or the fleshier part of the finger, as my teachers would say. So that's number two. And then number three is, even with the hand high enough, sometimes our fingers get a little messed up like that and they get a little flat. So keep them nice and square. I would practice this every day, 20 times each finger. And then move it to the string and practice tapping on the string too. Now Mr. T has been doing this for a long time. I've got pretty strong fingers, so don't expect your own fingers to make big sounds like mine are yet. Keep working on them, and then pinky finger too. But for right now, I would practice tapping those first and second fingers. If you're a violin viola player, doing those taps every day. All right, so those are some habits to avoid in the left hand when we start placing fingers down on the string. Sorry, I'll pluck it for you. Once we learn our F sharp, E, and D, that's one of the first pieces we can play. It's not in the book. You'll have to remember it by ear from when we would study it on the recorder. Good luck. Right, this is for cello players and bass players. I'm sorry I don't have a bass today to show you, but they're the same basic idea. Basic. Bass. Get it? Now, this is all about some of the habits that we have that might happen, some of the bad habits that might come along. One of the first ones I want to talk to you about is how that thumb addresses the back of the neck. We think of the neck right in the middle here. It kind of has a spine, like the spine on our back. That's where we want our thumb to be. One of the first bad habits is that thumb is flat, and it does this shape instead of a bent, flexible shape.
So what I do with all of my students for bass and cello is I ask them to just tap gently on the spine of the neck. And that brings awareness from our mind into what that feeling is like. And hopefully it relaxes all this muscle here, this big muscle for the thumb. And it also makes sure that the thumb is on its tip. So that's habit number one. One of the next habits is that sometimes that thumb likes to slide around in funny different places. We want that thumb always under this finger, the middle finger. It's very important that that architecture is there. If the thumb starts sliding around, our fingertips get weaker and it's harder to press down the string. So, remember that shape is a C shape when we bring it to the instrument? Remember Mr. T's game of catching a big piece of fruit that falls out of a tree, coconut, mango, pineapple? Whatever, you want to feel that gravity into your arm. We bring that heaviness to our instrument to let it sink into the string. And we bring that C shape to the neck, thumb on the back, and we let our fingertips sink in this way. Now see my arm here? Good habit is having a nice triangle this way. Elbow to fingertip to shoulder, and that triangle is complete. Now one of the first habits that might happen to your arm is you keep it close to your body because it's easier that way. We're holding up the weight of our arm this way, and sometimes our arm feels more comfortable this way because the weight gets held up, but we get weaker when that happens. We want to stay strong into the string. So, a few more exercises. Hold our fingers up tall. Yeah, I know you can't see my fingertips here, but let them fall onto the string and sink in. You'll feel the cello or the bass into your body when your left arm sinks into the string. We maintain that angle for our arm, like an eagle wing, not a fried chicken. The last thing that can happen is sometimes our fingers get flatter. They collapse on the joints. We want to see our rounded fingers as much as possible. Violin and viola players play like this, with a little smaller squares. Ours are a little bit more relaxed, but never let them be flat like this. Always curled to the tips. You might even try a little bit of swinging over here until you find exactly the right angle for you. And each string's a little bit different. See how firm the fingers can sink into the string with gravity's help. One of our first bad habits is to squeeze with the hands this way to try to press the strings down, because it can be difficult, especially for you, my bass friends. The bass strings are very thick and hard to get moving down into the fingerboard so they make our first note. We want a sound that rings. Cello friends, and bass friends, I'd also recommend tapping a finger every day, 20 times per finger. With four fingers, that makes 80 taps per day. I do it on the strings. And again, like I said to my violin friend, my fingers are very, very strong. I've been doing this for a long, long time. So don't feel at all that you need to sound like this yet. It'll probably make a sound like this. Okay? Keep working at it every day. I guarantee you'll get stronger arm muscles to move the fingers, and tougher fingertips that make pressing down the string easier. Only practice 10 minutes a day on this stuff, because you will get tired pretty quick. But with time, you'll be practicing more and playing longer and being able to do all of these things. You can do it. Thanks very much, my cello bass friends. Good luck. Last, I just want to tell you quick about the practice routine I would advise you to do, fourth graders. I would start off with some bow work. Practice your finger strength, getting them in the right place, making sure we have a bump on that thumb, and then doing one of the rhythms on page 11, just one per day. You could do more, of course, that's up to you. And then I'd go back over to page 10 after I put my bow down, and I'd work on one of the pieces that uses G string. So we're practicing going between our three strings. This really helps us learn all of our strings that we use most often in orchestra. And then last, I would go on to some of the left hand exercises that we just started, whether it's twinkle, where we're putting down our first finger on the A string, or we're practicing our F sharp and E new notes. Some days you can only practice one of those three pages because we don't have enough time. Other days you might feel like practicing for a longer time. But as a fourth grader, 10 minutes is all you need to do, only on the days that you breathe. Good luck.